Hello and welcome once again to this energy literacy training. And let us begin our journey to become energy literate with this module number one. What we are going to learn in this module is that our realization that we use a lot of energy. Indeed, you may not have the feeling right now how much energy you are using, but by the end of the presentation, you'll get some idea about it. Well, anyway, let us assume that we use a lot of energy. Let us assume that you use a lot of energy. With this assumption, what comes in your mind? Take a pause. Feel that you're using a lot of energy. What comes in your mind? You feel good about it? Or you feel bad about it? Anyway, doesn't matter. Whatever feeling that comes inside you is fine. Just feel something, you know, that you're using lot of energy. So let us establish this idea, this concept that we use lot of energy. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a series of images, and what you need to do is watch these images carefully and figure out what is common in these images. Look at this and figure out what is common in these images. All right, ready? Let us start. Image of a tile. Okay. A road. Furniture. Remember what you have to do? Figure out the commonality between all these images. So furniture, flowers, a toothpaste, a tube light, a basketball, car, carrot, a signal post, pen, lamp, umbrella, toys. So these are all different images that I have shown you, right from the road to signal post to flowers, basketball, all kind of things that you have seen. Imagine, realize what is common in these images. Can you tell me? Think about it. What is common in these images? Well, many of you would have guessed rightly that all these objects that I've shown you either use energy or they need energy to run, or all these have used energy earlier in their own manufacturing and production, isn't it? So one thing, one common thread in everything that I've shown you is the use of energy. How? We can look at into a little bit more details. Well, not only these objects that I've shown you need energy or used energy, but in our daily life, we have many things that requires energy that we are not aware about it, but I will make you aware. How? Let us see. Let us take an example about one activity that uses energy. An example I'm going to show you here is a very simple example of brushing teeth. And I hope everybody who is listening to me have brushed teeth in the morning, isn't it? If not, your neighbors would know whether you have brushed your teeth or not. But anyway, let us take an example of how much energy is required in brushing teeth. Do you have any idea, any guess how much energy we use? Probably not. Anyway, let us see. In order to brush teeth, what do you need? Number one thing you need is a toothpaste, isn't it? And if you need a toothpaste, then first of all, a toothpaste needs to be manufactured. For that, there has to be machines. The machine will have to take power. A lot of things will have to happen before a toothpaste can get manufactured, isn't it? not only that you need to manufacture the toothpaste, you need to also package it. And for packaging, what is required? You need a cardboard to make that box. And on the cardboard, you need to print something. That also requires energy. So packaging also requires energy. Then what else? After toothpaste is packaged, it has to be transported. The toothpaste that you're using, you never know where it is manufactured. 100 kilometers away from you, 200, 500, 1000 kilometers away from you. But it has to be transported. That also requires energy, isn't it? What else? Not only that, the toothpaste needs to be stored. It needs to be stored in a shop or a mall where you go and buy the toothpaste. Storing toothpaste also requires energy. Lights have to be on, ACs have to be on, all kind of things are running. That requires energy. You go and buy the toothpaste. That also requires energy. This is the journey of toothpaste. Imagine, you know, right from the production of the toothpaste to the packaging, to the transportation, to the storing, all requires energy. But what? You do not only use toothpaste for brushing your teeth. You need many other items, isn't it? What are the other items you require for brushing your teeth? Well, you require toothbrush. And for the toothbrush, you have to get the same journey done, isn't it? What are the journey? Manufacture it, package it, transport it, and store it. What else? You also need water pump. For water pump, again same, manufacturing, packaging, transporting, storing, all requires energy. What else? You require wash basin, and wash basin is a ceramic material. Very high temperature is required to make wash basin. So making wash basin and storing and transportation, again lot of energy is required. What else? You also need a water tank. That also requires energy in all kind of operation. You also need pipes to pump the water into your tank. And pipes are steel, you know, iron. You require a lot of energy to manufacture, to melt it, to manufacture, give it a shape, transport, package, everything. You also require a mirror to see your face in the morning. Mirror, again, is a quartz material, requires energy to manufacture it. And you require bulb to see your face, right? Light is required in your bathroom, so you require bulb. Imagine so many items are required to brush your teeth. And all these items takes energy. Not only that, not only the manufacturing, packaging, and transportation and storing of these items, but you also need electricity to turn your bulb. You also need electricity to pump the water up. That's also energy, isn't it? Imagine how much energy is required. You know, oh my God, so much energy is required in just one small task of brushing your teeth. Just one simple task, isn't it? Few minutes of activity. Based on this, can you imagine throughout the day, every single day, how much amount of energy is required in the spaces and things that you use in your daily life? It's really going to be a lot, isn't it? I hope you got the sense of it. Well, now let me ask the question again. After knowing that we use a lot of energy, after knowing that you use a lot of energy, what comes in your mind? You feel good about it? Or you feel bad about it? Anyway, I just wanted to put this question to you so that at least you start thinking about it.